were discussing about the importance of the coronation of Charlemagne. Coronation, the crowning of Charlemagne or Charles the Great as the ruler of the Roman Empire by the Pope Leo III. Now we were discussing, we have discussed many importance, but the most important significance, the most important significance of the coronation of Charlemagne was that it had laid or sowed the seeds of conflict, future conflict between the state and the Pope or Church. Like Charlemagne was friendly with the Church and the Pope. He was a very strict and very strong ruler. So while he was the ruler of the Roman Empire, the Pope and the Church remained friendly with the Emperor. But as the days passed, time passed, there was a quarrel between the Church or the Pope and the Emperor. Like Emperor said that I am the Emperor and Church is in my territory, so the Church has to listen to my orders. But the Church said that the Emperor is crowned by the Church. The Emperor has to get the approval of the Church, as Charlemagne was crowned by the Pope and the Emperor, whoever is the Emperor next, so he has to take the permission from the Pope to become an Emperor. And so if the Pope approved the ruler as the Emperor of the Roman Empire, then only the person could become an Emperor. So the Pope said, or the Church said, that my authority is better, my authority has to be more. But the Emperor said that no, it is my authority. I will control everything, including the Church and the Pope. So this was the condition. So Charlemagne's coronation had paved the way or sowed the seeds of the future conflict.
He was not only a
great administrator, but he was also a very learned person. So he had given patronage to the art and culture. Now, Charlemagne had wanted to restore the lost glory of the Roman Empire. So he had established his new capital at Athens. Was the new capital of Charlemagne, and this capital city was beautified by various palaces, gardens, libraries, everything, and the houses or the buildings were decorated with beautiful marbles. And now he was himself an illiterate, but he was a learned person. He did not know how to read or write, but he was a learned person, because he had in the court of Achaean, he had many scholarly people. And amongst these scholars, there was Alcuin. He was a great scholar of that time. He was the counselor, that means minister, of Charlemagne. Then we come across the other scholar, like Peter. Peter, he was the author of History of Lombards. Then there was his biographer, Charlemagne's biographer, Einhard, the biographer of Charlemagne. So these were the very scholarly people who adorned the court of Charlemagne, and he had tried to spread education. With the help of these scholarly people, Charlemagne had tried to spread education in all over his empire. He had set up a palace school where the children or the boys of the noble families, they used to come and study. And also he had set up many schools in his entire empire. The cultural development during the rule of Charlemagne came to be known as Carolingian Renaissance. Now let us learn about the Carolingian Renaissance. Now, what is the meaning of this word Renaissance? Renaissance is the meaning of rebirth. Rebirth. Renaissance meaning is rebirth. And Carolingian, because it had occurred during the rule of Charlemagne, that is why Carolingian. From Charlemagne, Charlemagne had lighted the flame of education and learning, as well as the cultural development, during the dark